is Wednesday, March 27th, 2024. I'm Chris Remo, and welcome back to the New York Times Crossword Daily Solve. It's a Wednesday puzzle, which means midweek, mid-difficulty, and it's still themed. So this midweek, mid-difficulty themed edition of the Daily Solve has been brought to us by Gita Karudi, Josh Allen, Mike from Vermont, and, as always, the indomitable Shoalmaster. So thank you so much to those four. They're benefactors, of course, of the Daily Solve Patreon campaign, which means they keep this series going with their direct support. For that, I'm very grateful. Thank you to them. Thanks to everybody who's a Patreon supporter. If you'd like to join them, you can head over to patreon.com/dailysolve or click the description field link. I'm very grateful to that. Thanks to everybody who does. It really keeps the channel going. And there's also, of course, the official Let's Check the Crosses mug for benefactors. Thanks as well if you subscribe to the channel on YouTube, which is a big help itself. And finally, there's the Daily Solve Discord chat server, which you can join via a description field link. And thanks if you've done that. It's a nice friendly chat community over there. All right, let's get on to today's crossword, this Wednesday midweek solve. It is a themed puzzle constructed by Rich Katz, who's constructed around half a dozen puzzles for the New York Times, and it was edited once again by Joel Faliano. Let's start solving, see how we get on today. Classic Camaro. All right, this is one of these things that I think I almost exclusively know from crosswords, but there is a Camaro model, a Chevrolet Camaro model called IROC, I-R-O-C. I think it might be, someone told me this last time it came up in a puzzle. Someone told me in the comments, I think it might stand for something like International Racing something circuit, maybe. I don't know. I'm probably getting that wrong, but I think it's something to do with a race. It's named for a race, but anyway, that could be wrong as well. We'll keep going. I'm pretty sure it's the correct answer. Unit equivalent to 8 quarts. It's a car, by the way. I don't even think I mentioned that, but yes, that is a model of car. Unit equivalent to 8 quarts. Oof, here we go again. 8 quarts. Is that a gallon? No, it can't be a gallon. 8 quarts. I have no idea. I never remember these. Okay. 9 is close fitting, and it's an asterisk. So it's a theme clue of some sort. Snug, maybe? I mean, that seems fairly straightforward. I don't know what the thematic element is, but let's just try it and see if it works. Neuters. Well, if you neuter, you could spay an animal, which is, is it spaying for a female animal and neutering for a male animal? I think that's true. In any case, I believe that's the answer. Footballer's uniform. When I see footballer, I think of association football, you know, as opposed to American NFL style football. How does that help? Not sure. What about this? Without it, that's neat. Okay. I think snug might be wrong, because this, I immediately think, is ice. If you serve a drink neat, you serve it without ice. So I think that's probably the case here. To act like a bobblehead is to nod, I suppose. A bobblehead is one of those figures with a, you know, spring-mounted head, so it kind of nods up and down as it vibrates. Close-fitting, skin-tight. So there's something going on with the theme. We're removing the word tight here, probably. Something like that. Oh, so the football's uniform is kit. So yes, you could say, yeah, he's wearing his kit and it's got his, you know, sponsor's name on it or whatever. Okay. Here we have 15 across pico de gallo. That's a condiment associated with Mexican cuisine, which is chopped fresh tomatoes and onions and jalapenos and things like that. Okay. I was in San Francisco for a week recently and went to taquerias on numerous occasions because you can get extremely good Mexican food there and less so here in London. Anyway, 17, a bit green. If you're a bit green, you could be jealous, but my first thought was that you're a bit green. I guess it could be unripened as well as a fruit. I don't quite see what this is. I sort of want this to be an E, but I'm not sure what it is. And it is, because to be in France. So that's not in this case, even though it appears to be a sort of a cry of desire. Effectively, it isn't that. It simply is referring to the word to be in French, which is être, E-T-R-E. So that was my intuition about the E was correct, but I don't know what the rest of the word is, unfortunately. A bit green. I don't know. Okay, what about this? Imitation. Ersatz, yes. If you have a sort of ersatz seat, maybe you've constructed a kind of makeshift seat, kind of an imitation seat to serve your immediate purposes. Like some league games. Not sure. Recyclable material. Tin is famously recyclable. To veer quickly is to zig or to zag. Which do I think it is? Probably zag, because it is two eyes. Because release following the GameCube would be the Nintendo Wii video game console, which is spelled WII. Okay, like some league games, they're away games as opposed to home games. There we go, that took me longer than it should have. All right, don't go anywhere. Hang tight, it is tight. Hang tight, skin tight. Yeah, that's what it is. Okay, so we're removing tight from these words for some reason. I'm curious about these revealers, maybe I should look at them. With 36 across, mnemonic device for turning, wow, this is complicated, for turning 54 across. Or a hint to the answers to the starred clues. Okay, I think I know what this is. Because if you turn, okay, so if you screw in a screw, 54 across, actually, I don't really, oh, screwdriver it'll be. Yes, okay, you turn a screwdriver to turn in a screw and you use the mnemonic righty-tighty, lefty-loosey. In other words, if you rotate it to the right or clockwise, you'll tighten the screw, or whereas if you rotate it to the left, counterclockwise, you will loosen the screw. And righty-tighty. So yeah, I see. So we add right to the clues on the right side of the grid, and presumably over on the left side of the grid, we will add the word loose. Yes, we will. Wiggler in a child's mouth, loose tooth. And this is especially good, because they're sort of, we're putting tight off the right side of the grid, so it comes after the word skin tight, whereas on the left, we're placing the word loose to the left of the grid, so it comes before the word tooth. That's a very nice little bit of conscientiousness in construction. So I think that is all correct. Righty tighty, lefty Lucy, I guess, with an E, yeah. Okay, so maybe we look at these just to see. Like some paper and tea, loose leaf tea or loose leaf paper. You can have both of those things. And here we have naval threats. According to an old saying, loose lips sink ships, as they say. So lips we have here. Here we have rhyming partner of good night, sleep tight, and tight goes off the edge of the grid. And then finally, I think we can put screwdriver, no. Oh, toolbox tools, screwdriver is plural. There we go. Yes, that is correct. Great. Okay, well, good. I think we've completed the theme. The whole of the theme, I think, is done. All right. Well, that should speed up the solve. Blank islands home to Corfu, the Ionian Islands home to Corfu. Hooch is rotgut is a slightly quaint slang term for booze. Well, for alcohol, I guess. I suppose booze is itself a slang term for it. Three down, but then again to a texture. O-T-O-H, on the other hand. Baker of jazz. Chet Baker is a famous jazz musician. Like someone in point shoes, perhaps. This is referring to a ballet dancer, so they could be on toe, as you picture a ballet dancer to be. 13 down, a rich cake could be a torte. Let's look at this. T that comes before a Y. So this is in the Greek alphabet. So here we have the letter tau. And a snare to, oh, well, no, it's not a snare. It's to snare someone is to entrap them as a verb here. Surf, turf could be a reef. So by this, I think they sort of mean ground, sort of surface, ground surface in the water. So a reef, is it a coral reef? E.T. who once appeared on Entertainment Tonight. Oh, it must be Alf, who was, whose name stands for Alien Life Form, who was the title character in a sitcom, I think an 80s sitcom. So there we go. Alf must have appeared as a puppet on Entertainment Tonight. All right. Happy as a clam. If you're happy as a clam, you're elated. I wonder what the derivation of that is. I wonder how clams became associated with happiness. To talk the ear off someone would be to yap at them. And a pioneering ISP would be AOL, America Online, from whom many of us used to receive countless CDs in the mail. Bean in refried beans could be pinto beans, or a pinto bean, I suppose. Speaking of Mexican cuisine, with our pico de gallo. And here we have contents of some folders, email folders. To pound as a drink could be to slug a drink. I think is that right? This doesn't look very good. No, maybe not. Well, nauseated for a bit green looks good. That was actually a meaning that hadn't occurred to me, if you're feeling ill. But this doesn't look right. It seems to me to a texter. No, it's not. Oh, chug. It's chug. To chug a drink. Yes, there we go. Okay, to drink it incredibly quickly. So it seems to me to a texter is IMHO, in my humble opinion. And here we have a unit equivalent to 8 quarts. Is a peck, right? Okay. Not a unit I encounter frequently in my daily life. Here we have devoid of pork and shellfish, say, could be kosher. So the say there means these things aren't equivalent. They're not synonymous because kosher doesn't simply mean devoid of pork and shellfish, but the say means this is an example of that thing. So something that is devoid of pork and shellfish might be an example of a kosher meal. Okay, hot temper could be ire, anger. And American Idol is a television series. If something is prevented from being published, it's what? It's censored. It's, I don't know. What about this? Small fry, a tyke maybe? Child? I'm not sure that's right, but let's just check it and see. Name found when reading between the lines. Eli. So when you literally read between the words, let me do it over here. The words, the lines, you spell out the name Eli in there. So there we have it. Prevented from being published. Oh, killed, as in you killed a story. You prevented a journalist from publishing a story by killing it. Okay. Less green, maybe, is older. So, oh, right. So we had a bit green here, nauseated, and then less green, maybe, is older. So two different meanings of green. In this case, one of the ones I was thinking of before. Here we have another green. We have sea green. Lamar of old film. Hedy Lamarr is an old actor, an old-time Hollywood actor. And a place for some me time could be a day spa, I suppose. You could go to a day spa to have some time for yourself. End of an act, maybe. End of an act. Don't immediately see that, unfortunately. What about this? Rids of. If someone rids his house of insects, you could say he purges it of insects. Once a wolf, always a wolf, coiner. Must be Aesop, who famously wrote animal-themed fables. Or at least we attribute them to that name. Stick used for breaking. A cue stick could be used to break balls in pool or snooker, that kind of game, billiards. End of an act, maybe. Scene. End of an act, maybe. Scene five or something? Is there a particular number of scenes usually in an act? I want to say five. I don't know if there's anything. Is that that must be what's common in Shakespeare? Boy, it's embarrassing that I can't just immediately bring this to mind, but I think probably five, especially, yeah, because any other low number would be multiple letters anyway. If it were, I mean, obviously one, but if it were two, three, four, six, seven, eight, nine, you'd have to get all the way to 10 to be another single Roman numeral. And I don't think it's not going to be 10. Okay, so some 4x4s could be SUVs maybe, or ATVs actually. So sports utility vehicles or all-terrain vehicles. What about this? V in electronics could stand for volt. So there we go, ATVs. Casablanca role could be the character of Ilsa from the classic film Casablanca. And characteristic sound of Yoko Ono. Oh, a long O. So a long O because her name contains four examples of a long O. Yoko Ono. So there we go. If one did Zippo, one idled, didn't do anything, sat around. Not to knot something up would be to tie it up. It might be used while boxing, could be twine maybe, not boxing the sport, but boxing as in tying up a box, boxing up a parcel. Rosebud in Citizen Kane, well, here's arguably a spoiler, but Rosebud is the name of the character's sled in Citizen Kane. And although that is arguably a bit of a spoiler, I don't think it in any meaningful way affects, I don't think knowing that would really make any difference to about 98% of your enjoyment of the film Citizen Kane, because it doesn't, yeah, it's not that kind of story where that would matter all that much. And I only say this because Citizen Kane is a genuinely great movie that I feel has become devalued by the degree to which it is cited as a great film by default, to the point that I sort of suspect many people tune it out when considering a movie they might want to watch because it's sort of so ubiquitously mentioned. But it is, in actual fact, an incredibly great and entertaining film, and should be seen. Anyway, 55, don't be evil, former Google motto, right? I do remember when they used to parrot that. 63 across, fork part could be the tine of a fork, the little spike, and soft caps. Berets, a cap that you wear that's literally soft to the touch, I suppose. I mean, it's not a hard cap, I guess. It's more to the point. Okay, here we have Honest Abe, which was a nickname for former President Abraham Lincoln of the United States. Here we have first four of a noted series, A, B, C, D, I suppose. Noted series being the alphabet. I assume that's what that is. Base jumper, e.g., could be... Oh, a daredevil. So someone who undertakes, you know, dangerous stunts. Program operators are users, people who use a computer program, say. And Where Joe Was Biden Time abbreviation. So this is making fairly straightforward, punny reference to President Joe Biden from Delaware, who can be abbreviated DEL. Arab bigwig could be an emir, as in the leader of an emirate. And chum in champagne. So this is, in this case, champagne is being used to refer to the place in France as opposed to its eponymous drink. So we simply want a word for chum or friend in French, which is ami. And here we have grip it and blanket. Grip it and rip it, golfer's mantra. Okay, well, that's new to me, but seems like it's the answer if you hit the ball hard. Sorry, I had to sneeze and cut out a little bit of the video there. Okay, if you reclined, you laid down, maybe? No, lain, as in she has lain down. Okay, she has reclined. So blue, because Blue River of Waltz is the Danube, famously, the famous waltz, the beautiful Blue Danube. and Timothy Leary's study. So Timothy Leary famously studied LSD, the psychotropic drug, and an Asian honorific could be Shri, which is indeed, as it says, an honorific used to convey respect to someone you're addressing, and then New Blank Hat Brand. Oh, I misspelled, I was thinking that looks strange. I misspelled Danube. There we go. New Era, I guess, is a hat brand, which sounds more plausible. And there we go. So there we go. That, I mean, that wasn't a total, certainly wasn't a total pushover of a puzzle, but it didn't feel all too difficult. I mean, it probably helped that fairly early on, I decided to go ahead and tackle the theme because that meant I was able to fill in 9 answers pretty quickly because we had our 3 revealer answers and then our 6 additional theme answers. So our mnemonic device, righty tighty, lefty loosey, which applies to using a screwdriver, allowed us to fill in skin tight, hang tight, sleep tight, and loose tooth, loose leaf, and loose lips. So a very nice, I think, very well-constructed theme by Rich Katz, which followed its own rules very conscientiously, because it allowed us to imagine actually writing the words tight and loose outside of the grid and then continuing the theme answers accordingly. It came together very well. So well done to Rich Katz, the constructor, and thanks to you for watching me solve it. That was the Wednesday crossword. I'll be back tomorrow with the Thursday crossword, another themed puzzle, possibly a particularly interesting or surprising or intricate theme. We'll just have to come back and find out. Do join me for that. But until then, please do have an excellent remainder of your Wednesday. Take care.